China. There's the Harley. The original Harley is right here, which doesn't look as sleek as the one that fits in the flip tail here. So, I've got my tools set up. And we're ready. Okay, so what I've done is I've put masking tape on my rear fender. Because, you know, masking tape is cheaper than paint, obviously. And then what we'll do is we'll disconnect the wiring harness for the tail light and turn signals. And then our hex head 5/16 that hold the fender on with the brackets to the bracket. And we have to just take the turn signals off. And then we'll take the tail light. Okay, so on the internet, when I was researching the Harley light, they were talking about the brackets that hold the light into the pocket. And I just noticed on my Jeep, they're also broken as well. And they go right here. And these ones broke as well. So that light was ready to fall out at any time. So, because I was under the impression that it was the actual holes that were breaking. But see, it's the actual clip. Now the Harley one's supposed to do that too. That just bolts in there with a number 3 hex head screw. Right in, and it plugs right in there, and your tail lights plug in on the other sides. So let's see what we can do here. And I'll show you what I've done.
So on the internet, what they were saying was
they go through these holes here. You over tighten them, and then it cracks from the vibration, like on this old one. Now, as you can see, the Chinese one, it's blacked out completely. I should have turned it on so you can see it. This one here is smoked, so hopefully it'll make a big difference when I'm riding, because you want to be seen. So what I did was I drilled out a 1/4-inch hole, and then I'm going to put these grommets in, hopefully, to stop the vibration. I'm going to glue them in with some 3M panel bond adhesive, and hopefully that's going to help with the vibration. Maybe I'll put some 2-sided tape on the back so that it won't such a vibration. The other version, the Chinese one, and the Harley, as you can see the tail, the Chinese one, how long it is, and with the Harley one, how short it is. So what I've done is I've taken drywall tape like this, and I've cut it out to go on the back of this, and then I put the panel bond right on top, and then I put the tape over top to squish it in there. So this should reinforce the backing. It's almost like a carbon fiber. The panel bond 3M. I'm not sure where you can buy it. I'm in the body business, so I get it from a dealer. But UAP, any of those kind of Pep Boys, maybe. Anyway, that's what I do.
The tail end here, there's the wire connectors for your turn signal, right there, left and right. And this is for the actual tail light. So you want to disconnect this and then take out your turn signal.
Okay, so I have the fender removed, and since I have travel bags, so those are the brackets that hold these through into the fender. Here's the fender upside down. The old bracket I got to take out. This is the wiring harness, biggie. This is factory wiring, so we're just going to leave that just the way it is. And we're going to remove this. We save these brackets for the housing, which is right here. And, so I put the bracket back in. I've hooked up the wire. I don't know why, but this wire should actually be on this side, but it's not. You have to just bring the harness back a little bit. It just seems like it's way out, but you just got to pull it out a little bit so it comes across, because then your left and right tail or turn signals go in there. So I'm going to put a little grease on where the fender sits. Start bolting the back again. There's a groove for the wire for the turn signals.
Turn signals those plug into their separate pieces here. Just a push in plug. And the tail light plugs into the one up there.
It's always good to check, make sure you got them plugged in where you left, just in case.
Okay, so after a night of drying, here's the glue with the drywall, the fiberglass drywall tape, embedded in it. So hopefully this is going to help for these tabs not to break. Now I notice on the back it says Revision B. Now this is manufactured in 2016, on the fourth month. So hopefully this will change it so it won't break. Now what we're going to do is we're going to install this into the housing here. Get that running. Hopefully it'll all work. Okay, so there it is on. Definitely a lot brighter than